I'm done fighting!
He's not going to kill me.
Don't shoot! I can pay the goods. Take them. You can take the goods.
Stay calm. It's us.
Great job, Atyom.
Atyom, all of our guys are fine. You did great. A shame we couldn't do it quietly.
So? You guys ready? Ready to set off? Too late if you're not! We have no time to waste!
Good luck, guys. I hope the winds are fair and the waters are smooth. And Artyom, watch it out there.
Oh yeah, we're gonna need that luck, alright. Fair winds.
Hurrah! Man your stations! Weigh anchor!
We're gonna go about halfway there, then wait in the reeds until about 4 o'clock. We want to get there early in the morning, when the fog is the thickest and they're sleepy after the morning prayer.
Artyomich, Duke, you're on final approach. There. See that fire at the very top? That's the control post. What used to be, anyway. Now it's a shrine, believe. Closer to God at the top, you see? That's where you have to go. I'll distract the guards now.
You are short! Catch the line!
you do to your barge? What you gonna sell now?
Oh, you're so funny!
Jackass.
So, Artyom, shall we move? Whoever gets there first wins. Break a leg.
Artyom, Duke, the Aurora is quietly moving into position. We'll be ready to act on your signal.
Roger that, sir. We're on it. Over.
Like you missed the morning service.
Well, I didn't.
One day you are going to get sent to fight demons for that.
But it's so early.
Just tell me what he said.
All right. Saw her with the heretic.
So you think they might have helped?
Who knows? They are the heretics. May the dark beast devour them.
Those heathens.
You see, the Simon's back.
Back? But he and Creel vowed to eradicate all the demons. You don't just come back and stop. Well, ask anyone. They got captured by heathens, but a heretic, one of the new ones, freed them. Simon just got caught. That's all. Of a story he failed not to go. No, he did not. He came back and with a huge fuss at the church and got his way too. Now we will be praying for that heretic instead of Simon. You got that? Oh, God. For a heretic? It would please God, though. That's Simon. What next? Then he just made the sign of the cross, kissed the altar, and went back to the demons.
Yes. What about Kirill?
He's the one who's going to do the praying. Father Salantius himself wiped his slate clean.
Oh yes, not everyone is created the same. God save Simon's soul.
Don't you worry so much. Well, I just can't kill him. The Four Eyes didn't come back. God save his soul. And he didn't even go out to fight a demon.
Well, you know what?
Now you don't even know what's worse. It's been a month since anybody returned from a trip to the House of the Fish.
As if people return from a demon-killing trip for what?
Well, how about we come with you? We'll do it together for sure.
Don't even think about it. I'll handle this myself.
No, just tell me if you change your mind.
and the sea is boiled, and people turned into shadows. But our cloisters survive. For the faithful reside here. And the Lord, in his mercy and wisdom, has chosen one among them who goes by the name of Silantius. And so speaketh the Lord, I will be with you, and will keep you safe, provided you are true in your devotion. Provided you reject satanic technology,
we reject.
And even more so, do you reject Satan's defense? That thing they call electric time. This curse is a new game to the school, so that they would fancy themselves above reproach, above God, and more powerful than him.
We reject.
Amen, my children. For the electric is Satan's temptation and his poison. Only those who reject electricity will be allowed into the kingdom of God. Only those who remain unstained by its corruption will be led through by this army.
Glory to the beast.
So let us not fear the heretics at our door. The ones who would attack our cloister. Even with their iron feet standing before us, stinking of machine oil and shining its heretical light upon us, we will not falter. Let us steel ourselves against them, for this is our hour of glory. Amen.
Amen.
So let your hands slay the enemy's servants. With glory, for we carry out the will of our Lord, and it is his retribution and punishment for their sins that our enemies will...
Responsibility to take my flock. I could. Just don't shoot. And tell the driver to keep it slow. The bridge is in shambles, so don't stop, or the bridge might collapse. You will have
Aurora,
to jump.
Duke here, we've reached an agreement. They will let us through if we don't shoot and move forward. But don't stop. I repeat, do not stop. Over.
Artyom, let's jump! Well, that's a job well done, huh?
We left Volga behind. The endless expanses of Russia stretch before us now. The bridge dwellers had finally decided to believe that we were not demons and let us pass. Anna was right. We invaded their world, and it's not up to us to destroy it. No matter how stupid it may seem. Electricity is a sin. Is that really worse than the lies we were told in the Metro? About how the whole world was...
Artyom. Artyom. Wake up, dear.
Is he up yet? Artyom, the colonel wants you on the bridge. See you later.
Come on, wake up. You did a great job there. We are not home anymore, so we'd all better act like you did. Smoothly. It's not like there's many of us humans left now. So I hope someday we will be able to trust others just because. Because they are people too. Am I bothering you? Sorry, I'm in a philosophical mood today. Stay here for a bit, Artyom. This is great. I wish I could stay like this forever. Artyom, when you climbed those ruins back in Moscow, with your radio, did you imagine our life on the surface at all? A home, for one. A place where we could live. A log cabin on the outskirts of a forest. Or how about a bungalow on an ocean shore? Oh, you know. There's something great in simply going anywhere like this, together. Through the abandoned stations, the ruins, the wasteland. Especially in our own private compartment. Thinking back, isn't this our honeymoon trip? It certainly feels like one, even though it's a bit late. We've only had some honeymoon sorties at best so far. You know, I had a talk with Katya. I'm sitting here recalling that bridge and those people there, and we've been sitting underground for 20 years, and they haven't. So what? These are not the same people who used to build cities, planes, and space rockets. They are just like us in Metro, only even more dejected. They are, essentially, slaves. For real. They work all day and pray all night, always watched, always directed. Everything is under control. Everything is decided by the community. Well, I mean, Silantius. They don't even have any property. Even their socks belong to the community. They're just entranced with him, with his ridiculous lies about electricity. Of course, not everyone got fooled easily, but if they dare ask questions, they get penance. Exercising an electric demon with prayer and the cross. But that's a death sentence. Leaving already? Well, go get them, Tiger.
Uncle Tom! Uncle Tom! Uncle Talkative has already set his shop up!
Wanna go look? It's so cool!
Here, Uncle Tom!
Ah, hi, Artyom. See my new place? Fit for a king, I must say. What do you think of this workbench, eh? Everything is within reach, yet there's so much space left. Most of the stuff you and the guys found outside and gave to me went into making this workshop happen. So thank you. We'll have to keep pitching in like this, too. Looks like we're facing a long journey, and useful things like ammo or equipment don't grow on trees. Plus, the further from Moscow we get, the harder they'll probably be to get. So don't forget to collect all the materials you find to keep us going. There's so many things to do. I haven't decided where I'm going to work on the suits, but I'll have to, and soon.
A smoke break. That's good.
Oh, this is one mean smoke. Damn, this is rough. Well, nothing we couldn't take. Well, you are the right kind of guys. You, the colonel, Duke, that guy did a swell job on that bridge.
It's high time we fixed our uniforms. Some of our people are starting to look pretty bad.
Artyom, come on in, have a seat. Stepan's putting on a live performance here.
So, Artyom, are you up for a jam? Come on, pick the guitar up.
Thank you, Stepan.
I'm sorry to ask, Katya, but Nastya's father. He's dead, isn't he? Does Nastya know?
He is. I tried keeping it a secret. Told her he left for the market. Around 3 days passed, and I still kept it in.
Stop it already!
I just sat there with a needle in my hand.
Well, what did you expect?
So, Artyom, the colonel's waiting for you on the bridge.
Talkative was mad. It's a long story. Come on, out with it. Well, there I am, sitting on a beam, looking at Artyom milling about below.
Oh, you are so full of it. Artyom did most of the work.
That he did. Yeah, he did. But you don't have to interrupt my lies. You asked me about the vest yourselves. All right, go on. So I see Artyom get to the door, and I think it's time I came down. So I do. But something just holds on to me.
What does?
How should I know? It's dark. Nobody around. But I can't move. And those locals kept going on about Sai something. So I thought I was in a kind of a bind.
So?
So I just unfastened the safety and let down. There was that shed down there. The roof was kind of close.
And what about the Tsar?
Oh, blue! The Tsar was huge! Scary as shit! And there was this rusty bolt, and my carrier got snagged on it.
Well, you, Duke, are lucky you already have a nickname. That's hilarious.
Talk with the Ark! All thanks to Tokarev. He got the decoder working.
Ark, come in. Come in, Ark. Over.
Hey, this is Ark. Identify yourself. Over.
This is Colonel Svyatoslav Myonnikov speaking. I'm in command of a special operations force. We have received your signal and are currently heading your way. Do you copy? Over.
Yes! They hear you loud and clear!
Who am I talking to? How do I address you?
The Deputy Chief of Communications Department, Major Ivanov. A moment.
Oh, yes, Major. I understand that the checkup is in order.
Great, Colonel. Melnikov? Extremely capable. I am sorry for the lack of trust, but as you know, the situation is dire, and the enemy is always ready to strike.
I do understand, Mitchell, and I hope that you can tell the leadership that my people are true to their duty and will be at their full disposal as soon as we arrive. Over.
Thank you for the great news. How large is your force, Colonel?
I have a squad of the best operatives the special forces have to offer.
A squad? I see. Well, this is great. Great!
Yes, we aren't a large force, but we bring a message of extreme importance. We are heading towards you from Sector K6 Alpha. Do you have any data on enemy forces we might encounter on the way? Over.
In just a moment, I have to check. K6 Alpha, you say? As far as I can see, there have been no enemy encounters reported in the area, Colonel. I regret. I must end our conversation here, but know that we are waiting for your arrival. I am making my report immediately, and I am sure the Minister of Defense will be eager to see you.
This is a great honor! Thank you! Just a few words more, though. What is the general situation there, Major? Please.
Colonel, sir, you do understand this is classified information.
But
I do understand you. We are doing fine. Do not worry. Well,
this now, you doubting Thomas? I'm so excited, my hands are still shaking. The minister himself! This is incredible! By the way, Artyom, you should take a look at the map. As you can see, we're heading almost straight for the Yamantau complex. Katya and Chris tell me that the line there is in decent condition. Surprising, really, taking into account the number of priority targets there. So, we can hope for smooth sailing from here, and right to the very destination. It's not even that far, but our speed...
We are approaching the Yamantau bunker, the final destination of our long journey. Direct radio contact with the bunker has completely dissolved Miller's resentment towards me for destroying our previous lives. He is eagerly anticipating the meeting with the Minister of Defense he was promised. Probably such things are important for a career officer.
To the safe zone and sit tight there.
We do that right now.
Stepan, you're in charge while I'm away.
Sir, yes, sir.
Great. Let's go.
Get out of this place. Where's the Moscow?
Artyom was right. People were coming here from all over the country.
Yes, they were. Nobody came from Moscow until now.
So much time wasted.
We'll make up for that now. Well, we're almost there.
Look, this is a bad place. Now, we should not come here. Really? Oh, see? Nobody home. How about we go back, huh? Bye.
Look!
Identify yourself.
Colonel Miller, here to report to the Minister of Defense.
And where are your people, Carl?
With the train.
It's dangerous outside. Contact them and tell them to take the train into the main airlock for decontamination. Welcome to the Ark, Colonel. Proceed through the tunnel and take the elevator. You'll be met inside.
Going underground, but this place, well, this is completely new.
Why is it so deserted here? No gun emplacements, no patrols, not even lookouts.
Why would they need any of that? A nuclear warhead couldn't take it out.
I wonder.
Yeah, this place could use some cleaning at the very least. Sam. Idiot. You know what? No need for us all to crowd the government. So you two better stay with Chris.
Yes, sir. Sir, yes, sir.
Speech. Reporting to the minister is no joke.
Ah, get off my case. I pulled an all-nighter.
Don't you feel like you should say something to Artyom now?
Yes. You were right, Artyom. And I was wrong. Thanks for not giving up. Minister, Commander of the Joint Special Operations Forces Squadron of the City of Moscow, Colonel Miller, reporting. I would like to request that my people are provided with temporary quarters and supplies, as there are women and children among us. Still, our fighters are in top shape and ready for action.
Women and children? Good. Haven't had those in a while.
Who are you?
Everything is going as planned. Everyone is fine. So far.
So far? I demand a meeting with the Minister of Defense now!
Do not worry. Everything will be just fine. And even better, the minister and the chief himself are expecting you for dinner.
Dinner? What the hell? Are you fucking mocking me?
Shut up! The doctor is talking!
Where is the government? Answer!
All here, Colonel. All here. We are the government you people deserve.
Don't you dare, you fuck! You're just fucking cannibals!
Calm down. You'll get jaundice like this. And believe me, nobody likes that bitter taste. The girl will have to wait, though. We must run the tests first. I don't like that cough of hers.
Untie my hands, you motherfucker! And I'll shove those tests so far up your ass, you'll be spitting
Watch
them.
Your tone, young lady. Do as that young man does. He woke up long ago, but quietly listens to wise people talk.
You fucker! Let me go!
So, Colonel, now you will pick up the radio and tell the rest of your people and the train to come here. If you don't want her to suffer for a really long time before she is served. Do you understand? And here I was hoping for an intelligent conversation for a change. Alas. That's not a problem, though, since this nice young man will surely do it instead. He won't dare be contradictory once we're done with you. Well, nice meeting you and all.
Yakov, you may start.
I'll get you even after I'm dead.
That may well happen, Colonel. I could choke on you or something. In the meantime, I'll excuse myself.
Come here! I'll rip you all apart! Every last one of you should have done that before the war! But I'll get you rot! Burn this town to ashes! So not even the dirty bones remain!
Now we'll be full again! Good.
Here. Colonel, sir, I think that's
Thank
enough.
Thank you, son. But it is not. We have to get them. But first, we must find Anna.
Sorry, I went too far with that elevator.
To hell with it! Idiot, start the main elevator up!
Thank you.
just like our old D6. Even the lift is the same, exactly.
True. That's quite fortunate. This way, we can hope to find Anna. Still, the complex is huge, and we have 10 minutes at the most. So, we'll have to split up. Sam, you check the filter room, the generator hall, and the storage. Idiot, you come with me to the command center. Artyom, you take the barracks and the sick bay.
Your floor, Artyom.
Blood!
Yeah.
Why did you shoot there? What the fuck?
But there was...
There!
Meet up.
Now I know it.
Artyom! I knew! Behind you!
There is always one like you! A hero! You're not saving anyone! Just like the others! So just...
Freeze!
Yes!
Let him go!
Don't kill me!
Now!
Remember what I told you. There was an ex...
Enough chatter! Are you all right, Artyom? Thank God. Let's report to the Colonel. Dad, it's me.
Anna, are you okay? Where are you?
In the sick bay. Artyom found me. My breath a bit. This whole situation, though. I thought we wouldn't see anything worse than that cult on the Volga. And that's Silentius with his damn fanatics. But no. It appears there was still space for growth. We could have gotten killed there. We almost got eaten here. That bastard. Unbelievable. To think he used to be a doctor. Don't matter. We'll see what happens now. We did survive him, after all.
In Moscow. Those keep people on the ground with their trust. Please.
All right, but what do we do now?
I have no idea. Have you found anything in you?
At the defense side, HQs, all the information is outdated. All links are long gone. Still, the ones that light up work for at least a few years after the war.
What's down there?
It's Caspian 1, a comm center. There's one more just like that in Novosibirsk.
Are you going to drag us to some other bunker
now? I don't know, Anna. We have to make the decision together.
Just interrupt him. It's getting quite hot here.
Did you get everything you could?
One moment. I'll finish breaking everything here.
Come on, come on.
Okay, all done.
It worked out. It really did. My concern is what if next time it doesn't. Of course not. All the more reason to strive and spend more time of what is allotted to me with that guy over there.
Ah!
think I believed those pricks from Hansa? I believed that Moscow was controlled by the HQ. That we were under occupation. That we were still in war. That there were generals here giving orders. What an idiot, Suka!
I will repeat my question. What do we do now?
Could we go back to Moscow? Tell them the truth about the war. The government.
They'll shoot us on approach. And even if we do break through, what can we do against Hansa? Who'd believe us with no proof?
What about going back to Volga? We could live there.
What do we do about the locals? They weren't exactly happy to see us there. Do we kill them all? Is anybody here up for that?
Back in Moscow, Artyom had been dreaming of finding a habitable place and building a colony there. Isn't it time we got to it?
The idea is good. But how do we find the place? Just keep traveling? The Aurora needs an overhaul. What do we do if it breaks down?
Satellites!
What satellites? You want to leave the fucking planet?
There's a satellite communication center on the Caspian Sea. It survived the war.
Oh. If we gain access to the data collected by the satellites...
We won't have to travel randomly. Radiation level maps, even your regular satellite photos could really help us out here.
That's an idea.
What if there is something worse than cannibals there?
Could well be. But first, we're going to be really careful this time. And second, does anyone have any better ideas?
I don't.
Well, I guess we've got ourselves a new plan.
Artyom, shall we look for that place you wanted? Sound the horn, then!
Three months on the road. 3 months of constant trial. But after Yamantau, we are ready for anything fate can throw at us. Mere kilometers separate us from the Caspian One communication center. Will the maps within yield a spot free from radiation where we could finally settle in peace? I don't know. But what's left for us but hope? The desert is taking its toll. The crew suffers from heat and thirst, and the Aurora is not in her top form. We're out of coal and had to switch to burning available fuel, old cross ties and twigs.
I'm not in love with this place. Nothing but sand and heat. I feel like shit here. Artyom, a car! Somehow, I don't like this welcome either. Let's go!
They stopped in that village there. Looks like somebody lives there.
I see. How are the men doing, Demir?
Stepan is the worst off, but the others are not so well either. Oh, only us here are still in fighting shape.
Better. Ara, you and Demir reconnoiter the area. We need to find the damn bunker and hit the road as soon as we do.
We might have a slight problem with hitting the road, Colonel. There's barely enough water in the boiler to make some tea. And we're all out of coal.
I see. We'll need to address that, too. Anna, Demir, one more task. Look for Walter and Kira.
Will do.
Get the men ready. We need to set up defenses.
Roger that.
Artyom, come here! Artyom, we have to learn who those men with the car are. They do look like regular bandits, but we can't take risks here. The car was headed for the village. Looks like they have a comms relay there, and it should hold some info, which is just what we need now. Move out as soon as you're ready. Crest, can your rail car pull the train?
It might, but really slowly and not for too long. The engine is too weak for the weight.
Hi, Artyom.
We don't have much diesel left.
All clear. Clear.
Train. Idiot, you get the engine. I'll clean the place up, then we'll bring Stepan. It's cooler than in the train.
Your word is law, my liege. Shall I commence now?
Commence!
Okay. Are you going out? Look here, then. This is something I finished just now. Well, I hollowed out a couple of Tihar bullets and filled them with explosive. Some explosive ammo right there. Now, you can do it yourself. It's quite simple. Don't forget to clean your guns regularly, with all the sand around.
Do you see that building with the antenna? The car went that way. Be careful out there, though. We don't know what to expect from the locals.